Good morning, Homestead, and please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for a moment of silence.
What's up, Homestead? I'm Carson Scheiber.
And I'm Bailey Hauser.
And this is HHS On Demand for Thursday, February 14th.
All JCL members are encouraged to attend our meeting this Thursday, February 14th, after school until 3:30. We will be discussing our major upcoming events and enjoying special refreshments. Please attend this important JCL meeting.
Hospitality Club t-shirts are in. You may pick yours up if you have already paid. You may bring payment with you if you haven't paid yet. Shirts are $11 and checks can be made payable to Homestead High School. Be sure to plan on coming next Thursday for our Valentine's Day celebration. We will be watching a movie and bring a snack to enjoy. See you then.
Attention seniors, if you forgot to turn in the Yellow Chips form, you can still turn it in at Student Services. This form is for the Franco Bannon Grant. If you are planning on filing the FAFSA by the deadline, you must also complete and return the Yellow Chips form to Student Services in order to be eligible for any additional grant awards from the State Student Assistant Commission. Please see Mrs. Bonif in Student Services if you have any questions.
Penny Wars runs through today. Bring in your pennies and put them in your fifth period teacher's collection box to raise your class total. Then bring in your silver coins or dollar bills and put them in another teacher's collection box to decrease their class total. All money collected will go to the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society, and the winning class will receive a pizza party.
Do you like art or music? Do other cultures interest you? If so, consider being on the art or music team to represent the HHS in the Academic Super Bowl next month. If interested, please see Ms. Padgett in room 522.
And now here's Ms. Malooly with a special announcement.
Hi, Malooly here, again trying to entice you to audition for the spring musical. This year we're doing Once Upon a Mattress, which is an almost fairy tale. If you like things that parody fairy tales or kind of make fun of them, this musical is for you. You don't have to be a part of choir or a theater class to audition. You don't have to be in a specific grade. Any grade can audition. Auditions are February 26th and 27th, and that's Tuesday and Wednesday, not next week, but the week after. And it's going to be in Shaw's room, which is room 414, and they'll start. You'll have to audition for a 1 minute solo where you'll sing a song of your choosing, and that's from 5 to 6. And then from 6 to 7:30, we'll have cold readings where you'll read from the script. Once again, that's February 26th and 27th, Tuesday and Wednesday. We will also have a list for callbacks up Thursday morning, and callbacks are February 28th, so just the day right after the two audition dates are done. And those are from 5 to 7, and that will include choreography and singing, and also some cold readings or some more reading from the script. So February 26th and 27th, everyone should come out, boys, girls, everyone, any grade, and just sign up for a time in Shaw's room starting Monday, February 28th. Thank you.
And now here is Drake White with a look at the Scholastic Art and Writing participants.
Hey everyone, I'm Drake White here with Mrs. Jones. Mrs. Jones, you have something to tell us about.
Yes, we are here to recognize several students who recently were participating in the Regional Scholastic Art and Writing Awards through the Fort Wayne Museum of Art. This is a competition that students enter both writing and art every year. We have several select students that were going to be sharing their work and talking about their vision. However, there were numerous students in both categories winning awards. Students can either receive an honorable mention, a silver key, or a gold key. Those students who have received a gold key will actually then move on to the next level of competition, where their works both in writing and art are compared with the other gold key winning students from all over the United States. And it's at this level that students may or may not then be moving on to the national competition in New York City at Carnegie Hall. And we've had several students at Homestead that have participated at this level now.
Now here are two of the writers that won awards for the Scholastic Art and Writing. This is Danny. Danny, what did you win?
I won a gold key and two silver keys in personal memoir and two for humor.
What were your three writing pieces about?
Well, the one I won a gold key for was actually something I wrote for Mrs. Christofferson, and we had to pick a person or a place that was important to us, so I talked about my lake house. And for the two humors, I just picked two of my columns and turned them into essays.
Scott, how many awards did you win and how many pieces did you write?
I wrote two pieces and I won two gold keys.
What were the pieces about?
One was about kind of like a my life story thing, and the other one was about a mission trip I went on to Nicaragua last year.
Tammy, you put in two applications for the Scholastic Art and Writing competition. What did you win?
I won two gold keys for two photography submissions.
What were your photography submissions?
Well, this project that I've been working on this past year incorporates drawing and photography. So I made this linear abstract design using ballpoint pens to make a backdrop. Afterwards, I found models to work this project with me, and so I drew on them, and basically that was my project.
Who is the model that you used for your photographs?
My friend Chase Bruton, who I met in my art class.
Josh, you also put in an application for the Scholastic Art and Writing competition. What did you win?
I won a silver key.
And what did you win it for?
I do three portraits of some kids in my art class.
Tell us a little bit about your portraits.
Well, as I said, they're simple portraits. They're graphite on bristle board, and I did them of Ellie Wood, Chase Bruton, and Allison Mansfield.
Just a heads up, those art pieces and writing pieces will be on display at the Fort Wayne Art Museum on Sunday, February 10th to April 17th. Free admission Thursday 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. and Sundays noon to 5. I'm Drake White, and that was your look at the Scholastic Art and Writing nominees.
And now here is Brian Hanford with a message for the student section about tomorrow's senior night game against Snyder.
What up, Homestead? This is Brian Hanford here to talk to you guys about this week's game. It's tomorrow night, Friday at 7:30 as usual. Show up at 7 if you want to get a good seat. It's senior night, so this week we've got a special theme. We're making everyone wear costumes. That's right, I'm going to be a hot dog, and it's going to be great. Then, next Tuesday, we play Northrop. We're going to do another blackout because our blackout was so cool last time. It's going to be a great way to end off the season. We need everyone out there for the Northrop game because they're really good this year, and we got to show them who's better. Let's go, Homestead.
Well, that wraps up this edition of HHS On Demand. I'm Bailey Hauser.
And I'm Carson Schreiber.
Have a great weekend, and happy Valentine's Day to Cassie Libby.